Recently, we found a special 150W GaN charger from REDMAGIC on Kickstarter. It supports PD 3.1 and has a stunning real-time info display. So we got it immediately, and let's open it up. Except for the charger, it also comes with many accessories. This is an AC adapter cable, which can convert an ordinary charger into a desktop charger. Just slide it into the AC socket. The length of this cable is about 1.5 meters. And this special cable adopts dual USB-C. The ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows it supports up to 240 watts and USB 2.0, and its length is also about 1.5 meters. The orange rubber cable is very soft, and the unique circular connector design sets it apart from the competitors. The last is a DC to DC cable, which has the same design as a dual USB-C cable, and the length is the same, about 1.5 meters. Let's take a closer look at the charger. It adopts a transparent DAO design. The DAO on the right is the high-end series of the REDMAGIC. You can even see the inductors and capacitors inside. The 150W is on the side. It's also equipped with an LED light in different colors on the front. The touch sensor is hidden under the transparent panel. You can control the display next to those upper ports by pressing it. As for upper ports, it has USB-A, two USB-C, and a rare DC port. The input prongs can be folded. Then let's see how fast it can charge your devices. First, the DC port can support up to 20V, 7.5A, that's 150 watts. When DC port charges continuously at high power, those USB ports only provide limited power. But once the DC port drops to 75 watts or below, the upper power will be automatically reallocated. Besides that, both USB-C ports can support up to 140 watts and PD 3.1, and the USB-A can only reach 30 watts. As for simultaneous charging performance, you can pause to view it. Because of the powerful performance and good compatibility, the power up strategy will be more complicated. Back to the charger itself, its size is about 100 by 71 by 35 mm, so the power density is about 0.6 watts cubic centimeter. And the weight of this charger is about 435 grams. It's about the same size as Apple's 140W charger. The critical feature that differentiates this charger from its competitors is the special customized app. You can change different light colors, set images on the display, and more advanced operations are waiting for you. The ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows it can charge your PD 3.1 power bank at 132 watts. And the DC cable can directly power those DC devices like photography lights, outdoor power station. The upper power is around 100 watts. Next, let's use ChargerLab Power ZKM003C to test its supported protocols. The USB-C one supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, MTK, PD 3.1, PBS, QC5 protocols. It also supports 6 fixed videos of 5V to 15V 3A, 20V 5A, 28V 5A, and a set of PBS. And two USB-C ports support the same protocol and PDO. The USB-A only supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, Apple 2.4A protocols. Now let's use this charger to charge multiple different devices. Two USB-C ports can successfully charge all devices like laptops, phones, tablets, game consoles, etc. Most devices can reach the fastest speed, and the charging speed of USB-A is much slower. We also try to charge three devices at the same time. The charging power of a laptop can be around 90 watts. The other two phones are only about 10 watts. But when charging two laptops at the same time, they can be around 80 watts and 60 watts. Next, we'll use it to fully charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro. The voltage is always around 28 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 5 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 120 watts for 20 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 97 watts, 67 watts, and 43 watts in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 1 hour and 52 minutes to be fully charged. We also turn it into another curve. The charger can charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro to 50% in just 26 minutes, and it can reach 80% in 48 minutes, 100% in 1 hour and 51 minutes. The charging time is basically the same as Apple's official 140W. You can click the upright corner to check that video. Except for the PD charging of laptop, we also use this charger to charge the REDMAGIC 7 Pro. The voltage can be around 18 volts. The charging curve can also be divided into 5 parts. It's stable at 89 watts for the first 6 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 82 watts, 69 watts, and 62 watts in turn. In the final part, the voltage drops to 9 volts, but the current increased. It takes only 20 minutes to be fully charged. So you can charge the REDMAGIC 7 Pro to 50% in just 7 minutes, and it can reach 80% in 13 minutes, 100% in just 20 minutes. Pretty fast. As for the standby power part, the power consumption at 220 volts, 50 Hz is 1.23 watts and 1.45 watts at 110 volts, 60 Hz, which is about 10.77 and 12.7 kilowatt hour in 1 year respectively. The standby power is much higher than most chargers we have tested. That's because it has LED lights and a front display. In the conversion efficiency test, the conversion efficiency varies from 69.03% to 92.47% at 220 volts, 50 Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 68.74% to 91.15% at 110 volts, 60 Hz. Except for the 5 volts, 3A USB-A mode, the conversion efficiency of other voltages can reach the average. Next, let's test its ripple. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, let's check out its ripple without load. When the output is 28 volts, 0A, the highest ripple is 24 millivolts peak-to-peak. For the other 4 states, the ripple is relatively low at around 10 millivolts peak-to-peak. It's beyond what we expected. Then move to the ripple test when loaded. The overall ripples are higher than without load. When the output is 28 volts 5A, the highest ripple is 79.2 and 70.4 millivolts peak-to-peak respectively. When the output is 5 volts 3A, the lowest ripple is 27.2 and 29.6 millivolts peak-to-peak respectively. We also put the charger into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test. After an hour of 140 watts output, we got the maximum temperature. Under 220 volts 50 Hz, the front is 72.5 degrees Celsius, and the back is 69.6 degrees Celsius. Moving on to the 110 volts 60 Hz, the maximum temperature on the front and back is 75.9 degrees Celsius and 74.8 degrees Celsius, respectively. Whether 110 volts 60 Hz or 220 volts 50 Hz, the maximum temperature is around 73 degrees Celsius. It's relatively hot, but still complies with the IEC 62368 standard. Well, that's our test for this 150W PD3.1 GaN charger from REDMAGIC. 3 USB ports and a DC port are enough to charge all your different types of devices. With the in-foam display and LED light, it's perfect for those tech geeks who put it on their desktop as a power hub. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can go to Kickstarter to support them if you're interested. Don't forget to drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!